Hello and welcome to round one back nine coverage of the 2019 Vintage Open. I'm David Lopez and I've got D-Money Darrell Morris with me.
Hey, hey.
Darrell, we're headed into the back nine here at Old Post Park DGC. It's a beautiful day for disc golf. We have Kevin Jones, who's sitting at 6 under par. We also have Gregg Barsby, who is at 1 under par. We have the lefty Chris Clemons at 4 under par. And defending champ Joe Freeman rounds out the card. He's also at 6 under par, tied with Kevin. So we're headed into hole 10. Darrell, tell us about hole 10.
So hole 10 is a par 3, 280 feet. It's basically a hyzer out over the road for those backhanders. They'll probably just throw something at it. It's kind of like a mid and try to get it right to that hole, bring in those three trees, and maybe try to ace run it.
Yeah, probably one of the easiest holes on the course, so we should see some birdies here. All right, looks like Kevin's up first. And it looks like he's just going with a putter.
Yeah, he's going to go basically just right of that tree, the big tree. Yep.
That's ideal. And there is a little bit of a ditch there. And if you land in that ditch, you're not going to skip towards the basket. It's going to just stall out your shot.
Yeah, it's going to say some expletives. That's it.
Yep. So as long as you get over that ditch, you'll be fine. Here's Freeman.
There's a... he's going out there and bringing the hyzer in. That's more of what I'm used to.
Ooh. Buzz the tower there.
Problem with that is it'll skip left on him.
And he'll have a longer putt than he probably wants.
Yep.
World champ Gregg Barsby up. Easy hyzer. A little high, but it...
Ooh, wind grabbed it.
Hit a branch. Hit a branch and sat down. Hit something, or it checked up and sat down. And lefty Chris Clemons going to just...
Flick.
Throw a little flick out there.
A little short.
He's a little short.
But he's got the picture frame right through the trees.
He does. So, he's outside the circle here. A little short on the putt as well. Joe Freeman up next for birdie.
He makes sure he's ready, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He takes his time.
Takes his time. There you go, Kevin.
Kevin will tap in. And Gregg has a little bit of a obstruction, but nothing too crazy.
Just straddle out
and tap in.
Very nice.
Very nice. Three birdies and the lone par from Chris Clemons, and we're going to head on to hole 11.
Yeah, I think if you are taking a par, you're probably losing a stroke.
Yeah, I would say that's probably a true statement. So everyone picks up the birdie except Clemons, and we're off to hole 11. Hole 11 is a par 3, 396. It's actually one of the harder par 3s on the course. A lot of players are going to go out to that right gap over the road, right where that sign is. That sign is right in the spot you want to throw. And they're going to try to skip back towards the basket on the hyzer line. Even if you hit the road, it's going to skip you back in bounds. So as long as you got a stable disc, you should be able to skip back towards the basket. Kevin's lined that up, and he actually was like, don't get hit, people. He was worried about those people.
Oh, yeah, because that's normally where he would throw. Yeah, every time I've ever seen him, he throws it out over there. And that's
he sawed it off.
That's not good.
No, he sawed it off, and he's well left, and he may be in the bushes.
And there is an opening over there
right. If
you get deep enough, so maybe he's okay in there, but yeah, it's not good over there. And that's just straight at it.
And that's that's the harder line to take.
And that looks really good.
That is pure.
Oh, he got a kick off there.
Yeah.
Very nice.
He's in the circle for a putt, for a birdie. Here's Barsby. Wasn't bad. Clips a tree. And he hasn't... Barsby's kind of struggled on the front nine to get going. Look at this flick from Chris Clemons.
Nice.
That's money. Look at that, right over the sign. Perfect throw. And checks up. And he's got a putt, a nice putt. But I was saying, Barsby's kind of struggled on the front nine to get going. Hopefully he can pick it up on the back here. Nice little up.
Yep.
Tap in that three. So Kevin made it to the clearing. And
So now it's a long putt, but it's unobstructed. So
yeah, he's just gonna have to settle for three, unfortunately.
Yeah. Here we go. These should be birdies here. Oh no.
Oh. He's gonna wanna.
Can't go through the cage.
No, he's gonna want that back.
There it is.
Good two. Good two for Joel Freeman. Yeah. He's gonna stroke the card. Everyone else gonna tap in for their pars. And I know that basket says 14, but
yeah, they're
tournament layout
adjusted for the goal.
That's right. Hole 11. All right, Darrell, tell us about hole 12.
Yeah, so basically the score is
-7
for Jones and -8 for Freeman. He picked one up, and then 4 and 2. But this is hole 12. It's in the long, so 295. So you're going to be going down this gap, and the normal hole is over to the left. You can kind of see the pipe over there, but they're going to go further, and it's right against the edge of the area by the road. So if you hit on that hill, it'll funnel down towards the road. But some people will throw it out over the road and bring it back. Or they could flick it down the left side and bring it.
Right.
There's multiple routes to get there.
Looks like Joel's going to line up the sidearm.
So he's going to
try to.
There's a forehand.
Oh, he forced it over, but it's not coming back out.
No, that's way over by the original hole.
Yeah, he's even maybe longer than that.
What's interesting here is when it comes out of that gap right there, it catches the wind that's coming off that water, and it just depends on what it does with it. That looks really good.
That's a good shot, but he's a little deep.
2-4.
Mm-hmm. Kevin Jones problems. And Barsby grabbed his Jumpman Eagle. And it's going right at the basket.
That looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit of skip to the left, but he should be fine.
Yeah, he's got a nice look at it. Chris threw what I thought was a perfect shot.
Oh, it caught the branch.
And he hit that branch.
Yeah, and once they get out and it's clearing, everything's just wide open. You just don't want to go too far or to go down that funnel that we talked about. So it's kind of a little mini death putt, but they can make it from back over there anyways. They'll probably run it.
Yep. Jump from Kevin. He was about 45 out, I think. Joel here, I think, is about 40.
That was a half run there.
It was a half go, huh?
Yeah.
I want to say Gregg is inside the circle, maybe right at the edge. He's 30, 32 feet maybe.
That's a beautiful putt for that.
Yep, bang.
If he misses, it's just going to drop.
That's right.
That's very nice.
And he's going to pick up a stroke on the card, and he needs it.
Yeah, he needs to get it going.
He's trailing right now. Jones to clean up par.
Very nice.
And then we're going to have Chris Clemons and Joel Freeman tap out for their threes, and we'll go on to the next hole. All right, so Gregg picks up the birdie and moves up to 3 down, and he's 5 back of Joel Freeman at 8 under. This is hole 13, one of the most scenic holes in Arkansas, I'd argue. Par 3, 310 feet. Players are just trying to clear this pond and not hyzer out anything over there to the left. There is a drop zone if they do not make the island. The paint does not apply here. That's from a previous tournament. But just an easy shot, really. You can go right at it. You can throw the sidearm. You can throw a hyzer backhand. So looks like Gregg's going to throw the forehand.
Well, that's a beaut.
Perfect. In the circle. Great shot. That's a common play here. Joel Freeman also going forehand. Right at it.
Ooh. Ooh.
Tap in.
Almost looked like a touch to pole there. I mean, these are just drop-ins.
Oh, yeah. Looks like Kevin's going to
putter.
Maybe throw the same putter he threw on hole 2 and hit the cage with. Oh, yep, he's going right at it again.
it's looking pretty good.
And then he walked in front of the camera, and we lost it.
Couldn't get out of the way.
But Kevin's in the circle. He's got a putt at it. Chris, the wind got it.
Yeah, not good. I mean, to me, this hole's made for him. That lefty route.
Yeah.
Bringing it in makes it a lot easier. But you make putts like that.
Yeah, make the putt. It don't matter.
Yeah, great putt.
Kevin from about 20, 25-ish. Cards his birdie. Walk it down.
Nice line, man.
Joel and Gregg there are tapping in. We should have a star frame.
Which it should be.
On this hole, this is definitely, you know, these players need to be birdie in this hole. They're kind of laughing about Joel's shot in the right here.
Oh,
he's talking about when he aced it last year at Vintage. Joel Freeman aced that hole last year.
Cool.
So, star birdie, star frame. Everyone picks up a stroke. And here we go. Hole 14, par 3, 325 feet. Big hyzer for most of these players. Chris is going to have to sidearm probably. That creek is out of bounds. It's flagged off, so you don't want to go into the creek or beyond because you'll be OB. But this is a pretty straightforward hole.
Yeah. Give it a chance.
Yeah, buddy. You see the
basket doing this? You're like, yeah. 16 all twos.
Yep. Pretty good.
Congrats.
Not bad.
Come on, buddy.
So we just wanted to give you a little taste of what it sounds like on the box while players are lining up their shots. Give you something a little different. Looks like Greg's just going to go backhand, which is standard play here, and that's it. That's
the line. Yeah, you still want to flip it, right?
Just don't want to flip it.
Go over that, and they got the OB painted out from the stream, so.
Right. Great shot by Gregg. He should be carding a 2 pretty easily. Joel's also going to go backhand with the hyzer out over the creek. His was a little higher and it carried more left, but...
We'll have a putt.
Yeah, he should be fine.
I expect basically the same shot, but Kevin should throw it out more to the right.
Yeah, I would expect that as well.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah, he's
a little long, though.
Here it comes. Oh.
Yeah, a little long.
A little long. He's going to... Have a forehand, nice look at it. Yep.
I'm sure. Yeah.
Same shot shape, just from the lefty.
Yeah.
Oh, it's rolling towards OB.
Looks like it's just hanging there.
That's close, and he's out of bounds.
Wow,
Not over the line. He's on the line, but not in bounds at all.
Wow.
Bummer. Here's Joel for his 2.
Hey, as long as you make it, you can take all the time you want. Well, besides 30 seconds.
Right.
He's taking all 30 seconds, though, that's for sure.
Chris got his meter in. He's about, I don't know, 20 feet maybe.
Good putt.
Good putt after a bad break. Because he threw a great shot and just got a bad roll. Kevin should make that no problem. Good putt, Kevin. It's going to leave Gregg Barsby.
All right. Put it in, Mr. Barsby.
Got a shout out Turkey over there in the background. He helped out quite a bit at this tournament. Yeah. Carrying water and chairs. Good putt by Gregg. So 3 birdies in the lone par from Clemons. And Barsby has caught Clemons now. Jones and Freeman at -9, -10 respectively.
Here he goes. All right, so this is hole 15. This is a crusher hole. It's all about just crushing as far as you can. The big tree on the right, there's a mando. You can see the arrows. They're trying to crush it past that tree, and then they're going to go back down towards the hole, 663 feet. It's actually a par 4. These guys, if they crush it past the mando, they're going to have a chance at a 3. So there's definitely birdie involved here. But the fun part is just to see how far they could throw it past...
Oh yeah,
that Mando. Piece.
Full on drives here. It's gonna be fun to see. And Gregg got a hold of this one.
Yeah,
And I believe that's a star boss that he has been throwing this tournament. Yeah.
That's the crush. He's past the Mando.
He's definitely past the Mando. He's going to have a good look at it.
Oh, if that would just turn.
Didn't want to. He's still past the Mando.
Yeah.
But he's a lot further away from the basket than Gregg will be. Now, Kevin's played this hole a lot, so he knows exactly how to throw this. Kind of losing the trees there, but as you see, it's kind of fading right towards the Mando. And it settles like...
Oh, that's a beaut.
Ideally where you want to be. Great shot by Kevin.
That's a beaut.
Got a little bit of turn. Look at that thing hook up on him.
Yeah, the wind's grabbing it.
Yeah, he's still in a good spot.
Yeah, they just got a long, you can see, pretty long ways. This is probably
long approach. I was going to say 275. He threw it down in the ground. He wasn't happy with that.
No.
This is me trying to get his par.
The thing is, if you get it close to the hole, it'll skip like crazy because it's worn out.
And Chris's disc did not want to hook up.
Never turned.
Oh, man. And then he gets that roll away. He's befuddled. So if you can get past the Mando.
This is interesting that he's going to forehand this.
Yeah. And I think that's a rhino.
That's a beautiful. I mean, dead straight. Never mind.
Wow.
What should I say?
Here he comes. Don't look now. Here comes the world champ.
Yeah, he's putting the gas pedal down to the floor.
Yeah, he is. He's got it figured out. And Kevin popped it up and got that tree branch. So I was kind of out of position because I was behind Kevin, and then Joel's like, oh, I'll just go.
Another little forehand here where he could putt it. He could jump putt this if he wanted.
He could.
Almost.
It's a good run. He's going to tap in a four for par. Kevin's jump putting his three. Just behind it. Good run. Chris has a clean look to the left of that tree. Yeah, just a little short.
Did that on another hole.
So he's going to tap in his four. This is Kevin for par.
Yep.
Easy.
Yeah, four's really not what they want here.
No,
these guys
know
they
definitely
should be getting three.
Correct. Joel's going to get a four. Chris going to get a four. And that means Gregg Barsby is going to stroke the card again.
And he's moving quick.
Here he comes. Here he comes.
He's moving quick.
All right. So now we have KJ USA at 9-under, Gregg Barsby at 6-under, Clemons at 5-under, and Joel Freeman at 10-under. Hole 16, Darrell, it's a monster, right? Par 5, 775. Players are basically trying to hit this gap and shape a shot that's going to land in the middle of this fairway. It's more of a placement shot than distance on this drive. And then from there, they have two options. They can go up straight ahead to the left or up to that right side you can see on the screen there and play towards the basket. So once they get around left or right, you can see the basket is kind of tucked into the trees over there on the right. The drone here is going to turn here in a second. There you go. And that's where they're trying to land, in that area, and get a putt at it. It's a long par five, a difficult par five, I'd say. But these players are definitely capable of doing some damage on this hole, I'd say.
Yeah, it's a monster for sure. But, I mean, it is something they could four. So.
Yeah.
That it all starts right here. I mean, you got to hit the gap.
So he's got the gap, and it's turning.
It's going left.
Oh, it didn't turn enough. He looks like he's in the thick stuff. Not good. I think forehand's a good play here, huh?
It is, as long as you don't just, you know, hyzer the heck out of it.
Right.
It comes back over into the right. Just a little flip-up hyzer, maybe, or an S.
Yep. And that...
It'll play.
Yeah, that's good. It's a good shot. He's a little left. He might have a little bit of a tricky lie, but he's a pretty good spot. Kevin, backhanding a mid. Oh, that's...
Oh, it's...
Wow.
Turn.
Perfect. That's absolutely perfect.
That's great.
This is a great hole for Chris. This drive is right here. Oh, he's got it.
Yeah.
Hook up.
He's going to be right by Kevin the way it looks.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great shot.
Those two shots are exactly what you're trying to do.
Yeah, look at that. Look at you. So now you got to decide, like you said, are you going to go right or left?
Yeah, and he's got a little bit of a tricky lie.
Where he's at, I assume he's going to go down the right side.
Yeah, I think he's trying to turn one over, and he didn't turn it.
Oh.
And he clips it. Oh, he clipped a tree.
Kicked right.
And it kicks right, so which is fine. He's okay over there. You're looking at the disc of world champ Gregg Barsby. He is trying to figure out what to do because he is not in a good spot.
Yeah, I mean, if you get high enough, you can go out toward the left and go along the highway. But I don't know if he's high enough up there to see that.
He's not. He is in the bushes.
Yeah, there's nothing over to the left.
There's nothing.
This is not a good spot.
No. He is in scramble mode.
Is he going to throw like a little roller or something?
It looks like he's trying to line up a roller, huh? Oh, he did. Oh, he hit the tree and it straight down. He's in the middle, but after two strokes, he doesn't want to be slightly in front of Kevin Jones.
No.
Kevin looks like he's going forehand. Yep. Right down the left side.
He's got to get around that.
He did. Oh, he did. That's a great shot.
He
should have an easy look at the basket for his approach. And wow. The turnover through the right side gap.
It worked,
but he hit a little gap. That seemed to like, for being a lefty, you'd think he'd just throw the straight down that left side.
Yeah.
But can't argue with the results, right?
Yeah. Yeah, what you can't see is the road is up there on the left.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't flip it over or it's going to go OB.
That one turned. And you can't see it because it goes over the hillside. But I just want to tell you guys, Gregg Barsby threw that forehand extra hard. It was incredible how hard he threw that. And he looked over that shot for a while trying to figure out a spot to throw that.
And see, he's stymied on that tree. It's a hard flick.
Yeah, he wanted to flex that more, and
you don't want
to
go right.
Oh, man, he's in the... That's not good.
If you get there, you better get through it.
Chris has a good look. Oh, yeah.
Right down the lane.
Right at it. Good shot by Chris Clemons. Kevin's ideal spot. He has thrown two perfect shots so far.
He's got that tree in the way, but as long as he stays low, which he did...
And
he's,
that's 3 for 3 on the exact shots you need for this hole.
It's a way to play it. Look at this.
About 90 feet out, way left. And I asked Gregg about this, and he says the basket was directly behind the tree.
Yeah, you probably can't even see. He's probably just aiming the right of that tree.
Yeah.
I assume.
Do it. Oh my gosh.
Never mind. Never mind. This is easy. It's an easy 4.
Maybe the best 4 you'll ever see on this hole. Just a 90-footer around the tree through the gap.
Kevin.
Look at Kevin.
He comes flying in.
He wants to see the lie.
100 feet over on the other side.
He wanted to see where he putted that from. What a great putt by Gregg.
Oh, yeah. This at least
for
he's
a birdie,
through.
For a birdie. Heck least, of a birdie.
At least he's through here.
Yeah. He did go through for the most part. Come on, get up. Oh.
Almost made that.
Good shot by Joel.
Very nice.
Chris played that perfectly. Kevin played it perfectly, assuming he makes this putt, which he should.
Yeah.
They both played that hole exactly how it's supposed to be played. Which is cool to see because Chris played it lefty.
Yeah, I mean, there's multiple ways to get there. It's a neat hole. Very, very, very creative hole. All right, so we got Jones at minus 10, Barsby minus 7, Clemons minus 6, Freeman minus 9, and they're starting to bunch up a little bit.
Yeah, they are.
All right, so we got hole 17, another beast of a hole. You're shooting down to this huge tree. You got to get it through this gap, and then you want to work it way up onto the left, right in here somewhere, so then you can shoot down another chute. Way out there, 665 feet, it's par 4. Once you get past that tree line, you want to come back on the right. You cannot go on the right side to come back in. It's just loaded with trees.
Right.
So we'll see if they can get through this gap, the initial gap.
He's holding that disc like he's going to throw.
Looks like a roller.
Oh, he did. And then he stood in front of the camera, and it went around the trees. But
it's not bad, but
no, he's
trying
fine.
To roll on this is next to impossible. This ground is very uneven.
Kevin's lining up a grenade, or I believe a grenade.
He's got to get that way up there to get over that tree.
Yeah. And it's hard to tell.
But he didn't get it over, did he?
He got over, but he clipped the tree right at the end, and he's still in a good spot, so he's fine. But it could have been a little further. Chris trying to gap it.
Oh, and now it just shoves it into that.
Oh, he's in jail.
That's not good.
That's not going to be friendly.
Why the forehands are interesting.
I'm a little surprised that he doesn't just backhand that gap. Maybe he's more confident hitting a gap with the forehand. Oh, it's turned, and he's clear. Wow. Cut it close. He cut it close.
Well, Clemons is in trouble. Yeah, I mean, he's throwing out sideways, and he went pretty far.
He overcooked that. I asked him about it, and he said he was trying to throw it hard to make sure he got out, and it just went clean. Ooh, that needs a hookup. Ooh.
It's a good bounce.
That's a great tree.
If that would have kicked in, he would have been in jail.
It's a great tree. Barsby here is looking at a nice line here. He's wide open.
Look at that. Man, he throws that well.
Oh, my gosh. Perfect shape.
And it's
skip.
And it's coming in where the basket's at. I mean, how do you... That's a
ridiculous.
Three. He's got a putt for a three.
Yeah. This is Joe Freeman. He's going
to... He wants to do the same thing that Barsby just did. And it's...
Hook up.
Got to come out.
It came out. And he's going to be looking at the basket, too.
Yeah.
So Chris overcooked his get-out-of-jail throw.
Big Heiser coming up.
Yep. Like, and he's trying to basically spike Heiser it over these trees back towards the basket on the right side.
Just don't push it too hard to the right.
Yeah. He went right between them, too. Not high over them, but right between them.
I bet he'll be okay.
Yeah, I think he's going to be good.
Again, he's trying to flick past that big pine tree on the right, and cannot go into those in the right. If he goes anything in those, he's dead.
Right.
So you got to make sure you're deep, at least.
He put some steam on it, and he's asking for it to slow down. He's got the shape, though.
Yeah, he's got the shape.
Look at what Chris ended up. Deep. This could be a.
How did it get back that four?
That's a great four. Great four. That was a scramble. Wow. He says, that's a real scramble. That's exactly what he said right there. Kevin for a four also, I believe.
Nice putt.
Bang. See that disc right there?
Yeah.
You know whose that is? Joe Freeman for his three. For birdie here.
Get it. Great three.
Great three. Played it very well. Couldn't have played it better unless you were Gregg Barsby. Look at this.
Yeah, he's par.
Oh, my gosh.
He has got the gas.
The video doesn't do it justice.
You know.
He played that perfectly. Here he comes. All right, so Jones at 10 under, Barsby at 8 under, Clemons 6 under, and Freeman at 10 under. Barsby is all of a sudden 2 back. Hole 18, par 3, the last hole of the round, 365. Multiple options here. You can go straight at it if you're gutsy. You have the hyzer line, and you have the forehand line. The forehand line is the most open gap, so I wouldn't be surprised to see players take that line. But most of them are going to want to birdie this hole. This should be a birdie hole for them. I think it plays a little downhill.
Yeah, and they could throw that low forehand over there to the left. Just got to get some heat on it.
Yep, that's it right there.
It's not going to skip. It's just going to stick, which it does.
Yeah, it does. He's got a longer putt than he probably wants.
You get up too high, and those limbs will just knock it down because we don't – this is not used that often. Very seldom
right.
We use this hole. It's a temp basket, so they don't clear any of this out or anything.
He threw that hard. That's and a he's destroyer.
Got he's got the height, and yeah.
Got a little checkup, but he's –
Look at a roll.
Yep, great shot. Looks like Kevin's lining up the forehand also. That's the play.
Same thing.
Oh, yeah, good height. Ooh.
Yeah.
Scared the basket there. Great shot by Kevin. I suspect Chris should handle this pretty well. Good flip up.
Got a little limb, but yeah. I'm still getting there.
He got a little more ground play. He's good. Looks like Barsby. Yep, Barsby is the furthest out. There wasn't too much wind.
Let's see if he keeps that momentum going for the next round.
I mean, he's tearing it up.
he's wanting to make this.
Oh yeah. Oh, he left it short. Look, he's wondering where the wind was.
What the heck?
Bang.
Putt.
Good two by Chris. Nice to end your round on a birdie.
Yeah.
Always nice to end your round on a birdie.
Yeah, it makes that nighttime a little bit better, and your thought into the next round
that's
way
right.
better.
A lot more confidence.
Yeah. Amazing what confidence does.
Great round by Kevin Jones. I believe that's going to put him 11 under. I'm assuming Joel Freeman makes this. 11 under.
Two good rounds.
Two great rounds. Barsby's going to come tap in his three. Boom. He had a great, man, he really killed it on the back nine. Great job by Gregg.
Yep.
All right, there's your scores after round one. Joel Freeman and Kevin Jones had the hot round on the day, and we have an interview, short interview with both of them coming up.
All right, I'm here with Kevin Jones, who I believe is leader in the clubhouse after round one. I think he is. Tell us about your round.
It was really clean today. I was giving myself chances on pretty much all of the long holes and all of the tough holes, so I was happy to have putts, and most of my putts were falling today.
All right, and you nearly got hole two.
Oh, yeah.
What'd you throw on hole two?
Oh, my 400 GPA two. I just threw it super flat and let the wind kind of take it, and it almost went in. It hit the cage.
Did you think it was in the whole way?
I thought it had a really good chance, but no, I thought it had a good chance. Didn't think it was in.
Anything you're gonna change the next time you have to play this course?
Nothing at all. I'm gonna play it exactly the same. I played really clean and I didn't get into any trouble at all, so.
All right, well, thanks for taking a few minutes, man, and good luck next round.
For sure, thank you, David.
No problem. All right, I'm here with Joel Freeman, defending champion from last year at the Vintage Open. Joel, I believe you're tied for first with Kevin Jones. Tell me about your round today.
It was an awesome round, an awesome card. We were all battling the whole way, so it was really fun to be kind of on a really good card. I think the TD did a really good job of handpicking the group, because everybody was playing really well the whole time. It was kind of that nice four-way battle you want to see right off the bat, so it was a lot of fun.
It was definitely an entertaining card. Did you rely on any specific disc or reach for one more than others today that you noticed on this course?
Not necessarily. I noticed I was throwing my Luster T-Bird a lot.
Okay.
It was actually kind of funny. Me and Kevin were talking in the middle of the round. I don't actually throw that disc that often, but I ended up reaching for it a lot today.
And that's why disc golfers bag so many discs, right?
Sure.
Because you never know.
You never know how the wind's going to be pushing or how you're going to be feeling a certain way or whatever. So.
Gotcha. Anything you're going to change going into the next time you have to play this course, which would be the final round, round three?
Most likely not. Felt really good about almost everything. Just some execution things, just like two or three shots that I kind of wish I would have, you know, gotten right out of my hand a little bit better. But
okay.
But beyond that, not really anything.
Nice. So. Well, thanks for taking a few minutes, man. Good luck in the second round.
Yeah, thanks
a
lot.
We'll see you out there.
Yeah.